now. Let's switch gears. Let's go from fountain pens to ballpoint pens. Hey, everybody. Some of you have seen this glass ball before. It kind of looks like a big golf ball. It's got all these, well, a golf ball has dimples, but this has facets. There's a difference. What I like about this, one of the things I like about it is the color of it. It's kind of a green. And I do like green. It's actually my favorite color. So I have some other green items here. I have this little green plastic box. I saw this box at the store, and I thought, hey, that would be a really great box to put fountain pen nibs into. And maybe if I can cut this divider out and cut this one out, maybe I can put ink converters in here also. So I don't know, I need to experiment with that. Here's a green lighter. I don't even know if I would call that green. What color would this be? Would that be a teal? Screen bottle cap. Here's another green bottle cap. Here's a little green AMC Javelin. Was it 1968, 1969? This was made by Tyco. It came with some electric train. Yeah, I had an electric train when I was a kid that had a freight car on it with a bunch of these javelins. You know what? Let me just get it. Okay, I retrieved it. And here it is. So there's three javelins. A white, a blue, and a green. On the bottom row are Camaros. They yellow and an orange and a red. And here's a green crayon. Doesn't write that well. It's a green pocket knife. Speaking of pocket knives, most of you have seen this one before. It looks familiar, doesn't it? This one will not spin. Somewhere around 1967, 68, Frito-Lay put these pencil toppers in packages of Fritos. So in grade school, we saw a lot of these. This particular character is, I think he was called W.C. Frito. And there's a date on it. Let's get a magnifying glass. Frito-Lay Incorporated. Yeah, it says W.C. Fritos on the side, so. What other green items do I have? Somewhere in the early 70s, Parker pen made a desk pen. This was meant to go, it's meant to go into a cube. Anyway, the cube is just a little square, about yay big, and with a hole in it, and you put this in it. And whenever you need the pen, you just reach over and take it, use it. Parker, made in USA. There's a nice green Pentel P205 mechanical pencil. And here is that Dryden slim fountain pen, the one that doesn't have a model number or anything. I told you that I would report back on this because I featured this in a previous video. I told you that I would let you know how well it did. Well, let me tell you, it did really well. This is a fine nib. And of all of the fine nib fountain pens that I've ever used, there's been a few, this has been the best. I've done a lot of writing, quite a bit of writing with this. over the last 2 or 3 weeks. And each time I picked it up and uncapped it and began to write, it always wrote. It has not dried out. It has not leaked. So I've been very, very, very impressed with this pen. If you want to use a fountain pen, let's say at work, and you like the fine nib, this is a very good choice. I think they come in different colors. I don't remember, but I bought this because it was green. I had never heard of the brand. Someone in the comments of the video where I featured this said that that these were produced to be sold on Amazon only, I think is what the commenter said. I don't know if it's true. Could be. That is where I got this, from Amazon. And in the description of this video, there is a link. So, if you feel so inclined to purchase one of these, you can just click the link in the description of this video. It'll take you right to it. So that's my report. I told you I would get back with you and let you know what I thought about this. And I think a lot about it. It's a great pen. Smooth, dependable. It writes on, I don't know, I probably wrote on 2 or 3, maybe 4 different types of paper. It did well on all of them. Now, let's switch gears. Let's go from fountain pens to ballpoint pens. I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. So these pens are Parker Jotters. Yeah, most of you have heard of a Parker Jotter. It's a very basic pen. It's got the arrow-shaped clip, the Lustreloy cap, and a plastic barrel. Though the very early Jotters had nylon barrels. If you unscrew the cap, I have a gel refill in this one. This is this Jotter was made no later than 1980. You can tell because the inside of the cap has threads that are made of brass. After 1980, the threads are made of plastic. So this is a very basic pen used in, back then it was used in, well, even today, school, offices. I don't know if this one will write or not. It's been sitting around. Oh yeah. Parker Jotter. It's a workhorse of a pen. I think these were first introduced in like 1954, 53, 54, somewhere around there. Mainly made them for the first couple of years with nylon barrels before they switched to plastic. At some point, they had a version, I think these are all standards, but they had a version that was a little bit fatter. I don't think it lasted very long, but nonetheless, it did exist. Wonder what kind of refill this one has in it. And that has a gel also. But the little plastic, the tip that keeps it from drying out is still on it, so. This one has brass threads in it too. So you know these pens that have the brass threads, these jotters with brass threads are at least 41 years old. How many do I have with the brass threads? Is this the one that had brass? Yeah, that one. That one has brass. And I have a few other jotters, but I just grabbed a handful for this video. This one has plastic threads, so you know it was made after 1980. But it was still made in the USA. They made these Parker Jotters in the United States until 1999 was the last year. And then they moved the production of the Parker Jotter to England, you know, across the pond. And I know they made these in Janesville, Wisconsin, up until then. I'm not sure if there's any other plants where they were made in the USA besides Janesville, but maybe, I don't know. This one has an inscription on it. It says, "With sincere gratitude for your years of service to the Parker Pen Company." So I believe I got this pen from my aunt. There's plastic threads in this one. I wonder if it writes. Oh yeah. Writes very nice. Very, 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 very nice. And here's one with an inscription in it. JAS Class of 58, 50th Reunion. So that would be Janesville High School. So in 2008, there was a reunion, a 50-year reunion. 2008, so you know this is going to have plastic threads. Yes, and it does. And it says on the refill, "Made in United Kingdom." It says UK, so made in the United Kingdom. That's about right, because 2008, that's where they made them. So they made them in the United Kingdom from, what, 2000 to 2011. And after 2011, they moved the production to France. And as far as I know, that's where Jotters are made today, France. This one says Aero Park. That was the name of the Janesville, Wisconsin production facility where they made pens. So this Jotter was made in Janesville at Parker's facility, known as Aero Park. And this is a commemorative pen. It says 1953. To 1999. So from 1953, I guess that was the first year of the Jotter, to 99, which would be the last year they were produced in America. They were made in Janesville. And this one has gold-plated clip on it, a gold-plated clicker button, and of course the Lustreloy cap and plastic barrel. And I would suspect the threads obviously are going to be plastic, and they are. But the refill does say made in USA. A lot of times you would buy a jotter and it would come with a matching pencil. Like here's a pencil. You can see that it has the pencil tip on it. So this would be the match for this one. Pen and pencil. I had a Band-Aid on my pinky because I'm not going to show it to you, but underneath on the bottom side our cat, not the cat that you've seen before, but a new kitten that we have. And kittens are really, really playful, and she's been clawing me up pretty bad. There's a spot there in my legs. She just tries to climb my legs like they were trees. Yeah, so sometime in the future I'll show you what she looks like. I think right now she's 12 weeks old, maybe. Now here's a new pen that I've picked up. These have been around a while, but I'm just now getting one. And this is a jotter as well. It's called a XL. And extra large. It's bigger than a regular jotter. And looking at the back, it says it was made in France. But I see the word Switzerland mentioned. There's a lot of countries mentioned on the back of this. It was imported into AU Canada by Par Newell Rubbermaid Office. Lots of by appointment to Her Majesty the Queen, manufacturers of pens, pencils, and inks, the Parker Pen Company, Litchfield. This other one says, by appointment to His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales, manufacturers of writing instruments and inks, Parker Pen Company, Litchfield. So, you know, I don't know much about the royalty, so that obviously has something to do with that. But let's go ahead and open this up. And the packaging has kind of a British flag type thing going on. These appear to come in limited colors. I think there are only about 4 colors to choose from. I guess there could be more, but that's all I saw. This is a matte finish. It's a very dark green. Let's hold it up to a regular jotter. So it is longer than a regular jotter. It feels very nice in the hand. It doesn't have the chrome tip that, you know, all the other jotters have chrome tips. It would have been nice if it did. Parker XL. Let's unscrew the cap. And it has your Parker refill. It says Quink Flow Ballpoint Refill. ParkerPen.com, 1 millimeter medium. It doesn't say where this was manufactured, this refill. It appears to be all plastic, except for the cap. And there are plastic threads up inside the cap, and the barrel has plastic threads. It has some inscription on it. It says IN. Not sure what IN means. Other than that, it just says Parker. But it writes okay. It writes like any other good ballpoint should. Standard jotter weighs 0.4 ounces, and the Parker XL jotter weighs 0.7. So, as you would expect, it is heavier. It feels better in the hand because of the, you know, this, the extra width. Like the width of this, right about where the barrel meets the cap, is 415 thousandths of an inch. Which is significantly larger than a standard Parker. You can kind of see the difference. The standard Parker is 375 thousandths, which is 3/8 of an inch. I still wished I knew what that IN stands for. I don't really foresee buying, you know, any additional Parker XLs. I guess I might if they came out in a color that I was really, you know, really wild about. Green is my favorite color, but not necessarily this shade of green. Now, this shade of green, that's what I like. That's the good stuff. This green, yeah, it's kind of ugly compared to this. But nonetheless, I'm going to use it. As a matter of fact, here in a few minutes, I'm going to work a crossword puzzle with it. That'll be a separate video. We'll see how it does. And in the description of this video, I'll put an Amazon link to this pen. I've started putting the Amazon links in the descriptions to help you find them if you feel like purchasing one. If you purchase one if you get to Amazon using the link that I put in there, if you purchase this, I might get 25 cents or something like that. So that would be sweet. A quarter. So we're gonna go ahead and wrap this up. I appreciate you watching. I appreciate you sticking with me. If you haven't subscribed, I sure wish you would. And I love it when you leave comments. And I like it when you share the videos. I know sharing an ASMR video can might you know, who would you share that with? I guess I'll go ahead and work the puzzle now. So I'll see you in the next video. Take care.